My new special, Junior. You know the first one, you was in your mama's stomach, man. Can you believe that? Yeah. You was there, but you wasn't there. Oh, and now look at this. You gonna bring me up on stage. My man Isaiah, oh, Uncle Isaiah over here. He started opening up for his dad when he was like 12 years old. You 10. He was opening up for his dad at 12. I mean, how did it feel to be opening up for your dad being in the comedy club?
It was a good experience, man. Good experience. Yeah, it was fun.
Right, so you got any advice for Junior before he go on stage?
Oh, just go up there, be yourself, you know, be a kid, you know how you are with your friends. Go up there and be that same LJ. You know what I mean? Kill the crowd. They're going to love you.
Man, that's right, man. Thanks, man. That was great, man. You got that?
Yeah.
I'm glad you gave Junior that advice. I mean, because now, you know, I just really see a vision with my man here. Mm-hmm. He got the tremendous, the look, the style.
Yep.
Since he started like you, you know, I don't need you no more, man.
You going for tonight? Because you for the special.
No.
Because we got more dates after this. You know, we got.
I know I told you you were on it, but I mean, look, you got it. I mean, it's in house. Keep the money in the house. Family, you know what I'm saying? Hey, Floyd. Get him a seat outside. Get him a seat at the audience. Can you go and do that, bro?
I can't sit in the green room?
Nah, man. I mean, it's for talent, bro.
You like family, man. But
we've been through a lot, though.
I know, man. I love you, though, baby. You know I love you, man. Thank you, though. Thank you. But let me just say this with you. I want you to do well, because, you know, just like I replaced him, I replace your ass, too.
No. Show your love for my man, Lavell Crawford.
I know what you're thinking. Lavell Crawford, he lost a lot of weight. And he got his hair back. And he looks like a kid again. Nah, he's still old and bald. Let me stop before I get 2 chops to the throat. Welcome to my dad, the one you came to see, Lavell Crawford.
Give it up for my man. Give it up for him, man. Yeah, boy, there you go. My son, man. 10 years ago, my first special, he was in his mother's stomach. I just made him. You know, I just made the mix, and now he on stage and think he a comedian now. He better get it together. I want 10% of that damn money. I want to make what you make. Shit, you ain't make what I make. That's zero. I ain't getting no damn money. Everything I get, go on your little ass. Teeth and haircut and fucking Jordans and shit. I'm like, who the fuck is Michael Jordan? He ain't playing no more. Charging that much of a fucking shooting. He can't play liquor basketball. He can't do shit. I got the Jordan. They hurt my fucking feet. I'm too grown for Jordan, man. They ain't for a man to need orthopedic shoes. You know what I'm saying? Man, thank y'all for coming out, Tempe, Arizona, man. Thank y'all so much. Yeah. This is my 5th comedy special, man. There's another one in the belt. Doing some crazy shit, times and stuff, but we having fucking ball. I don't give a fuck. It was supposed to be over a long time ago. We still hanging in this bitch. Still doing the same bullshit. Everybody going through something. Nobody can bitch no more. It's an even playing ground now. You know what I'm saying? White folks looking at the nigga like, hey, don't come to me. We're all in this fucking together. I'm fucking as scared as you are, man. They got a new president. Yeah, I don't know what the fuck he doing. Good luck, Joe Biden. I don't know. I ain't like Donald Trump, but Donald Trump was funny because he never shut the fuck up. You know, now you got Joe Biden. He almost lost to Trump. How you almost losing the most hated president in the fucking world? That tell me something about him. I don't trust his fucking ass either. And he ain't helping out. He ain't helping out black folks. Joe Biden. He still didn't do nothing for us, bitch. Only if you're a transgender. That's the only thing you get. You know, they putting transgender boys on the girls' basketball and the track team. We gonna win now. You know? except for that one to get injured out there on the high hurdle and hurt his pussy ball. Oh, Jessica hurt her pussy ball. And her dick came out of her shorts. I don't want no trouble. I don't want no half man, half woman beat my ass out in the street. I respect guys who want to be girls, because anytime you can still pee at a urinal and not get no pee on the front of your dress, you got skills, goddamn. Because I get pee all in the front of my damn pants just off the splashback, you know what I'm saying? And then I get a lot in my underwear because I thought I was done, you know what I'm saying? So for you to be able to piss in a thong, I salute you. How do you keep both balls in that thong? My balls be hanging out the side of my underwear. But I'm 52, though, you know. My balls sag, you know. They sag. They sag. You turn 50, it sag just like old titties. It's just like... Yeah, I learned that the hard way. I was sitting on the toilet, man. I was like, oh, my goodness, I feel some cold water. You know what I'm saying? But they do sag. My son, you know, you just seen him. He 10. He got a nice set of balls on him. I didn't look at him. I saw him. I was like, they fresh out the box. I said, hang on to them nuts, son. They ain't gonna always look like that. He was like, what they gonna look like, daddy? I said, like this little motherfucker. He was like, oh, my God, get that brown sock away from me. I said, that's not a brown sock. That's my balls. How your balls look like a brown sock? I say, keep it living, son. Keep it living. I think I'm going to go on that show Botch and give me a nut tuck. Yeah, you know, take all the excess skin out there. I want my nuts back. I want to look normal again. Look like I'm sitting on a bulldog. You know, and then you can't, and you got to be careful. They need to come out with some underwear for old nuts, you know? Like, they got, like, for old titty, they got push-up bra. I want, like, for men's balls, they need to come with a nut net, you know what I'm saying? Because I got in the car too fast, said dead on my nuts. I mean, they went between my legs and up my ass like I had two sets of booty cheeks. And I ain't even know, I ain't know these up there. I'm halfway down the highway. I'm trying to get them out between my legs. I'm swerving. And the police pulled me over like, what you been drinking? I said, no, sir. I'm trying to get my nuts out of my ass. He said, oh, you must be 50, drive on. Can't even make love to my wife, right? I'm 50, you know, I'm making love. I'm up there making love. I'm in there, bam! Bam! Well, let me keep it real. I am 50. It's more like bip, bip, bip. I double up on it. Bippity bip. And my wife like, stop. I said, oh, my God, am I hurting you? She like, not at all. What's wrong? He said, I felt something rub on my foot. I said, oh, it's just my balls. Put them on the bed so I can see them. I put them on the bed, rolled them on her like dice. Slap! We gotta laugh, man. We gotta laugh. People, we know what we've been through. I think we blessed to still be here. This shit should have, I think it was supposed to be over, but God just let it run a little longer than it should have. Because we've supposed to be gone in Y2K, and then we're supposed to be gone in 2012, said the Mayans. And we still fucking here. I got a lot of twinkies. I got duct tape. I got water. We ain't, the world ain't fucking ended. We still here. But it's getting kind of fucked up now, though. It's getting real fucked up now. We got fucking viruses and shit. We've been having fucking viruses. I don't know why this virus is so worse than the other one. We done had a lot of shit killers before. We had AIDS. Remember AIDS? AIDS was real fucked up. Nobody put no fucking mask on, you know. They wouldn't even put a condom on. Oh, she ain't sick. She all right. She ain't sick. She don't even smell like she's sick. Yeah, he's screaming real loud like he done that shit. Remember herpes? Yeah, big ass fucking bump on his lip. Hey, man, you got herpes? No, that's acne. Bullshit. Your proactive really ain't working. You know what? take your cups and your silverware home with you, you know? But now, COVID-19 is here, scaring the fuck out of everybody. It just came on the scene. Fuck cancer and leukemia, all those diabetes, all them diseases, COVID-19, which is on the back of a Lysol can, got us all walking around looking like we about to rob a train. This is the only time you're supposed to wear a mask when you walk in the bank. I walk in the bank, sir, you can't come in here without a mask. I said, thank you for warning me, sir. I put my mask on, came in. Everybody on the ground now! Everybody on the fucking ground now! I'm just glad he's robbing us with a mask on. I'd at least be safe. I don't want to get sick laying on this floor. Because people so stupid with this fucking mask. I'm so sick of you motherfucking me. Put your mask on. Put yours on, ugly bitch. Yeah. That stupid ass shit. I mean, you got to cover both air holes. Cover your mouth. Cover your nose. I can't fucking breathe. I need one of them open, motherfucker. What kind of bullshit is that? And they want you to put that cloth shit on your... You got a tampon on your fucking face. That shit hurt. It's in your goddamn nose. Got a piece of metal in the shit. And then black folk, we changed it up. Shit, I bling mine out, girl. I stood the shit all over. God bless me. I'm blessed on it. We just go too goddamn far. We gonna pimp our masks. Shit, And say, you know, the mask is so stupid because people wear them outside in God's fresh air. Birds still fucking flying around. They're like, look at that dumb motherfucker out here with a mask on. That's God's fresh air. What the fuck are you scared outside? I mean, I can't get on board with this mask shit unless I'm outside and a bird's gonna go, boom, then I'll be like, oh shit, this shit for real. It's for real, Lord, help me, Jesus. But right now, fuck that damn mask. I only wear it because I can't get in stores without it. As soon as I get in, I pull that bitch down. Just be walking around. Excuse me, sir. I'm so sorry. Did I have it down? It just fell down. I'm so sorry. This mask got a mind of itself. It don't work. If you can still smell a fart, you know these masks don't work. For real. I mean, for real, they don't work. I fought it on a guy with a mask the other day. I lit him up, too, man. I gave one of them silent but deadly ones right there. Ha! And it stank so bad, it looked like he came out with a knife in his hand. I was like, ooh, I ain't even going to look at him. I ain't going to even look at him. Hope he don't think it's me. I turned around, he looked at me right in my damn face. I'm like, what's your problem? He said, did you just fart? I said, did you smell it? He said, yes, I did. I said, well, your mask is malfunctioning. And you should be saying thank you because I just saved your life. Because if my fart getting through that mask, Lord knows, COVID-19 is following right behind it. I'm a hero today. This is the best time to fart, though. In public, it's like Fortopia out there, man. I be farting on groups of motherfuckers, be cropped on them, happen. They don't even know it's me. I can just stand by and just letting shit out. They're like, oh my God, it must be a sewer main broke around here. And I be standing right there, yes, this city is just falling apart. Because back in the day when you had to fart, stomach be bothering, you had to find a secret space to fart, you know? You had to find a place no one down, like in the grocery store, I find an empty aisle, usually where the disinfectants is, you know? Because if it stink too bad, I just spray some Lysol around, you know? You know, Lysol is so funny. It killed 99.9 motherfucking odors, but shit ain't one. But it smell like either you shit a bunch of lemons or you shit a tree. That's how it smell. And I mean, I killed that owl, man. I wiped that owl out. They need to put some cone down there. But then they always, old reliable nosy motherfucker come right behind me. Oh my God, we need a manager immediately. I think something died over here under these shelves. Sir, do you smell that? No, I do not. You don't smell that, sir? No, I do not smell it. And I got it there for you. I got arrested. This shit getting stupid, man. They think we dumb, man. For real. You go to the grocery store, they got street signs in the grocery store now. One way, left turn, stop. I went down, back down the aisle. This lady's gonna say, "Excuse me, sir. You got the wrong way." I said, "Hell if I am. I saw cream and onion potato chips down here. I'd be damned if I walk all the way around this fucking store to come back where the fuck I'm at. You better report me, ho. Because I'm illegal." This shit getting out of control because people be snitching on you. And I have your mask on. And nobody know all the symptoms and shit. So, I mean, you do something. Ah, look at him scratching his forehead. That motherfucker got that shit. Look, what you sniffing for, motherfucker? What wrong with you? Stay out of my house, you know. But I read on the can, Lysol kill COVID-19. Shit, I got the vaccine right there. I sprayed my face right away with some Lysol. It burned like a motherfucker by 40 minutes. Then I'm good, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I ain't trusting that vaccine. I seen that nurse. She said, "How you feel?" I feel all right. I feel better than I ever. I said, "Ooh, shit. Back to Robitussin and Vicks Vapor Rub. I ain't taking that shit. Fuck that." They came up with this fucking vaccine 30 minutes ago. People were like, "I'm in line." No, I'm not. Fuck that, nigga. I'd get some hot tidies and some chicken noodle soup and have the church pray for me. Fuck that. I ain't getting shot up with some shit y'all just made up in a lab 20 minutes ago. People take more time making crystal meth than they did. I ain't lying, though. Everybody, "I'm gonna get the vaccine. Take your dumb ass in there." Shit, I don't trust doctors anyway. Doctors always scaring your ass into the shit. I went to the doctor one day. The doctor goes, "Talk about, Mr. Crawford, you have high blood pressure." I said, "The devil is a lie." I said, "Your mama got high blood pressure." "No, Mr. Crawford, you have high blood pressure, and it's genetic." I said, "You're a damn lie. Only reason I got high blood pressure because I had to come in here and pay a $25 fucking copay, sit in your weight room for fucking 3 hours, and then come in your office to tell me I got high blood pressure. I tell you how to get it down. Give me my $25 back. Validate my fucking parking so I can get the fuck out of here." Now you gotta go to doctor online now. Anybody went to doctor online? Yeah, I mean, that's some bullshit. I had to go for a checkup. I'm sitting in front of the... I'm sitting in front of the web camera. Said, "Mr. Crawford, pull your underwear down and hold your balls and cough." I said, "You sure this is not Pornhub?" "And after that, I need you to check your prostate. I need you to put one finger in your asshole and tell me how that feels." I said, "I feel real uncomfortable." "Is there anybody else in there watching you while I stick this finger up my ass?" "No one else is in here, Mr. Crawford." He's looking around. Then my son come in. "Oh, Daddy, what you doing? Get out of here, boy. I'm in the doctor. I want to go to the doctor, too. Get your ass out of here. Why your finger in your butt? Shut up! I'm checking for shit." This shit out of control. I'm a gizzard man. I'm sorry. I wear it like I said, but I gizzard because they don't know what kind of mask you're supposed to wear. They don't know. I was going in the grocery store that day. The lady gonna say, "Sir, you need a face covering to come in this door." I went back to the car, came back in with a piece of notebook paper on my face. She's like, "Okay, come on in." I said, "For real? I got my son homework on my face. This is stupid." And that motherfucker be looking at you fucked up. You pull your mask out of there. "They the reason why we got this shit. Shut your stupid ass up. You don't even know what the fuck it is. You can't even die from nothing else. You gotta die from COVID-19. Man hit by a bus, then trapped in a car fire, then bit by 4 rattlesnakes, dies of COVID-19. Man gets decapitated, dies of COVID-19. He was decapitated. Yes, but COVID-19 was in his system. And some people worrying about COVID-19 need to worry about other shit. Like my nephew got a mask on. He all of a sudden he's germophobic, but he don't even wash right. He's in there with a mask on, but his white t-shirt collar brown in the motherfucker. I said, fuck that mask. Wash your neck, motherfucker. Shit. You got pandemic right here. And some people need to wash that damn mask. One of my buddies said, I had my mask on in the house. It smelled like shit. I came outside. It smelled like shit, too. I said, well, it's your mask. That's what it is. I said, your mask trying to tell you what everybody's been trying to tell you for a long time. You need to brush your teeth, gargle, floss, shit mouth. His breath still stinks so bad, Siri don't even want to talk to him. Every time you're like, Siri, how I find the Tempe Improv, a shit emoji come out. Like, no, Siri, the Tempe Improv, a skull and crossbone come out. You need to wash your mask and put some Altoid dust on the front of it. You know that Altoid, you know Altoid, they take them strong mints to be in that tin can, and they so strong, you ever see somebody put one on their tongue, ooh, it's burning, they leave it right there. It's helping everyone, leave it right there. Yeah, but but I think the fear of shit right now is more than the really thing. Like my uncle, he's 75 years old. He walk around. I pick him up, take him to the grocery store. He coming out with a mask over his eyes, mask over his mouth. He had hand sanitizer all in his chest hair. He had saran wrap all around his chest. He had rubber gloves on, rubber on his shoe. I said, what you doing? I ain't trying to catch that corona. I said, man, you 75. You got high blood pressure, diabetes, liver disease, plus a touch of syphilis. COVID-19 a die trying to get you sick. Sit your stupid ass down. Come on, man. I don't like the mask myself because it's a burden. You know how it is. You rush in. I'm going in the store real quick. I get to the fucking door like, damn, I forgot my damn mask. And my car parked all the way at the end of the fucking street. And it's raining outside. Like, fuck that damn mask. I'm going in the store anyway. I said, I wish a motherfucker would say something to me. I walk in the door, police standing with his mask on, hand on his gun, tell my sir, where your mask? I step back and put my underwear on my fucking face. I said, I'd be damned if I get shot when I have the mask on. And I walk in the store, and the lady said, sir, could you put that over your nose? I said, ma'am, if I put this shit over my nose, you're going to have to call an ambulance. I got the balls on my face. I'd be damned if I put that shit stain on my nose. And I just can't believe people done caught on to this mad shit so fast. These are the same people do some of the nastiest shit in the world. Sit at home, eat a booty hole out, blah, 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 blah. Then they ate a coochie, blah, 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 blah. Had a dick squirt all in your face. Then you wake up the next morning, I gotta go to the store, I gotta stay safe. Really? You afraid of COVID-19 and you caught COVID-44 last night? My cousin, he a little bit bigger than me. He weighed about 540, right? He got a nerve having mask on, but they don't make big and tall masks, right? His mask just covered his mouth right here. He's still eating under the mask. He putting french fries and hot dogs and shit under the mask. He was eating a rib the other day, ate too fast, ate the fucking mask. Y'all got another mask? No, you don't need one. COVID-19 will get lost in you. Try to get it. You're going to die from salad. Get the fuck out of here. I don't like the mask because it's a burden. I see the ladies, some people looking at me mad at me, judging me, because I'm talking about it like, I can't believe it. Shut your ass up. I can say what the fuck I want. We was just normal motherfuckers picking shit off the ground. You find a Cheeto between your seat, be like, God made dirt. Dirt don't hurt. Then all of a sudden, we done became germaphobes. Shut up. Get the fuck out of here. Ugly people kissing babies and shit, then don't even know where their lips been. But all of a sudden, I seen people kissing dogs. You know, I was on a fucking plane with a fucking dog sitting right next to me. I was like, excuse me, stewardess. This dog don't have a fucking mask on. I don't feel safe. The dog looking at me like, here you go with this bullshit. They don't make kids wear masks, and them some of the dirtiest motherfuckers in the world. The motherfucker sneeze. I can snot all over the place. I said, that's COVID-19 right there. Get out of here, little Johnny. And I ain't trying to lead nobody astray. Don't get me wrong. I'm not up here preaching. I just think that, you know, we should question a few things. Like Dr. Fauci, I don't even know who the fuck he is. He looked like COVID-19. I don't trust that motherfucker. He done had it for years. He's still around. And it must not be that damn bad, because the most hated president in the world had it, and he had it for 3 days. And he was right back up. You know, I was like, what kind of COVID he had? He must have had COVID-16, you know? So I had it, let me tell you, I had it, all right? I had it. I went down, Melania, help me. The next day, I felt better than I ever did before. I was like, man, maybe my blood is the vaccine. Maybe I'm the hero. I knew he wasn't going to win because his running mate is a walking dead. Anytime you sit up there and got a fly on top of your head and you don't swat that shit one time, you ain't alive, motherfucker. Come on. The fly's just sitting up there like this. And they're like, what you mean I'm on the head? You know, they keep calling it a pandemic. That's what bothers me, a pandemic. I think these motherfuckers just be making shit up, because it ain't a pandemic. You know why? You know why that fucking pandemic? I seen the movie. I saw the fucking movie, all right? Man, you show the movie, they got dead bodies hanging outside, abandoned cars, a crow eating a fucking dead eye out, motherfucking zombie. That's a fucking pandemic. This is not a pandemic. This is a mass demic. You know why this ain't a pandemic? You know why? Bill collectors keep calling my fucking house. How the fuck y'all still alive? Ain't nobody sneezed on a keyboard at the electric company. Ain't nobody coughed on a monitor at the gas company. Lady from the car note place called, Mr. Crawford, you're 2 months behind on your car note. I said, COVID-19. She said, oh my God. You have it? I said, no, my bank account got it. It has no taste, no smell. It has no funds either. We have it on a respirator right now, and we're taking it day by day. They be threatening to turn shit off in my house. Mr. Crawford, you're late on your payment again. We're going to cut your electricity off. I said, cut it off. Cut it off. You willing to cut my electricity off? Dude, a pandemic? My children don't have nothing right now. We don't have no food. We ain't got no livelihood. We gotta wear masks everywhere. Cut it off, motherfucker. You gonna cut it off in a pandemic? God, forgive your soul. You go, oh my God, calm down, sir. Anybody in your house have COVID-19? No, we do not, but we're suffering from it. Okay, Mr. Crawford, we'll give you an extension. We'll give you 6 months. 6 months? That's all you're willing to give me during a pandemic? Who knows how long this is going to go? They told us 3 months. They told us 3 weeks. You only going to give me 6 months? Mr. Crawford, calm down. We'll give you a year. If that's what you want to do. That shit worked like a motherfucker. It worked all day. He about to cut my cable off. Cut it off! You gonna cut my cable off in the middle of a pandemic? Cut it off! My children ain't gonna be able to watch SpongeBob. They won't be able to enjoy internet or nothing because you wanna cut our cable off during a pandemic? Oh, my Lord, what else are they going to take from us? Mr. Crawford, calm down. We'll give you 6 months. 6 months? The electric company gave me a year. Okay, we'll give you a year, too. Just a year? Okay, we'll match them and give you a year and a half. If that's what you want to do. That shit work on every bill company. It don't work on my wife, though. We was locked down. I was trying to talk her into something bad. I said, what you gonna give a blowjob? Put it in your mouth.
I'm sucking your nasty ass dick.
I said, really? You don't want to suck my dick? And we in the middle of a pandemic? I can't believe you would turn me down. We don't have nothing else. I said, all right, motherfucker. I'll suck your dick because I'm going through the same thing. I'm going through the pandemic, too. Since I'm sucking your dick, you're going to eat my booty hole. I said, well, let's calm down. Let's calm down. We got to stay safe. We don't know how this is contracted with... Eating booty hole right now don't sound like a good judgment. I'm gonna put my mask on and I'm gonna give you 6 feet, please. And this shit caught on fire. They talking about, I knew it was bad when they shut down the NBA. I'm like, no, not really. LeBron James makes $100 million a year. He can stop playing for 50 years, come back and still got $200 million in the fucking bank. LeBron got so much money, his hairline does what he want to fucking do. Really, it could be back here, then it's up here, then it's a bang, then it'd be a curly cue and come down to be a mustache, then it's a goatee, then it's a sideburn, then it's a shag. That's $1 million hair right there. Shit, I don't got that kind of money hair. My hair won't even grow up here. It's like it's a no trespassing sign up here. It's growing the size on my eyebrows, on my mouth, but it won't grow on the fucking top of my head. I got hair in my asshole. I don't even know why. I mean, am I growing a tail? You know what I'm saying? I'm about to call one of them hair transplants places like Bosley Medical or something. I said, can you transfer this out of my ass to my scalp? I be walking around brushing that shit. They be like, man, it stink like ass around here. I don't know what you talking about, but these waves are the shit. I'm about to give me a doo-doo rag. That didn't make me think it was bad when I seen them cut down the NBA. What made me thought it was serious when I looked outside and seen this homeless man with a mask on. I was like, wait a minute. What does Pissy Joe know? Shit. He was just eating out of that dumpster yesterday. Now he got a mask on. What has he heard? I mean, they think this shit's smart, though. They got curfews in some cities. I was in Nashville, I think. They had a 10 o'clock curfew, like COVID-19, smart as shit. Like, you out at 10:05. Bitch, what you doing out at 10:05? You done fucked up. I'm about to get all in your lungs. You know who I am? I be seeing people at restaurants, they'll eat and put their masks back up like COVID-19 playing double dust. Oh! Oh, bitch, you know, oh! I was almost up there. But see, you know, people get scared about that shit fast. I ain't trusting when they close down the churches. That was some bullshit, because I believe in God. I cuss and talk a lot of shit, but I believe in God. It ain't nothing but God that let y'all come down here to the comedy club and watch me tape a show. I don't care if you believe it or not, but God is good, man, you know? I mean, when he preaches up here, sitting there, his name is Jesus. He was born in a manger. His mother was a virgin. He came down for our sin. He came down for our iniquity. He came down to save our soul. He came down for our sentence. He came down for our burden. He walked on water. I said, he walked on water. He walked on water. Man said he was blind. He said, Jesus said, you ain't blind. Put this clay on your face. Peekaboo, you can see me. I can see you. Jesus, I can't walk. Get your ass up and get off that bed. Carry your bed on home. He walked on home. They said, Jesus, Lazarus is dead. No, he ain't. Get your ass out of that grave, Lazarus. You ain't dead. Get your punk ass up right now. Jesus, we hungry. I got 2 pieces of fish and 5 loaves of bread. Give me some Miracle Whip. That's right. Give me some Miracle Whip. I'm going to make tuna fish salad. He hung from the cross. And 3 days later, he rose from the grave. I said, 3 days later, one, two, three. 3 days later, he rose from the grave. Because death don't have no power. Death don't have no sting. Death can't hold me in the ground. What about COVID-19? Shut the doors. We going live stream. Shut the doors right now. We God tired. He done enough for y'all. People get mad I joke about it. I'm a comedian. I'm going to joke about this shit because some of this shit is funny. And I don't give a fuck. People dying. They've been dying for motherfucking many, many motherfucking years. This ain't the first fucking time we done died, motherfucker. But now they keeping count for real. You know, they died in 2017, 18, 19, more than fucking 209. They died. Motherfuckers died all the time. They ain't never keep fucking count. All of a sudden, we're dying. You ain't gonna live that damn long anyway. You're gonna live long to fucking up, and that's it. You ain't gonna live fucking forever. I don't wanna live past 80, 85. My damn self. I don't wanna be too old where I don't even know I'm alive. You ever seen them people? They so old, they chewing and ain't even got nothing in their mouth. You ever seen my. You hungry, Papa? Nah, I ain't hungry. You know, all that one motherfucker be shaking like that. He like you ask him a bunch of questions, he don't agree with him. What'd you shake your hand? You agree with me? Yeah, I agree. Why you keep shaking your hand? And some of them people be too independent. They be getting on my nerve. I was at Golden Corral. This old lady had that palsy hand shaking everywhere. She shaking corn and mac and cheese on everything. It was all in the fudge and shit. I was like, Miss Brown, let somebody get that shit for her. I got it. Just shaking. And she had a dog, too, and he's shaking, too. They both, like they in their own private earthquake. See, this is just scaring me, though. I ain't know. I'm glad to be doing comedy anywhere, man, because I ain't have shit to fall back on. Then, when they shut down everything, I went to college to drop my cousin off. I ain't had no money. I ain't had nothing to fall back on. I got nervous. I mean, we were in the toilet paper shortage. That shit scared the hell out of me. You know, I had to hold my shit. You know what I'm saying? Because we used to buy good, you know, we lived a nice life. We had good toilet paper. We had that angel soft with the four ply with the angel laying on it. I used to just ball it up and hit my ass and just drop it in the water. Ball it up and hit his ass, just drop it in the water. It sucked all the water out the toilet. I had so much toilet paper in that water. But when times got hard during that pandemic, shit, we moved from Angel Soft down to Scott. Scott is one ply, you know what I'm saying? But it got wood chips in it. You can't wipe all willy-nilly with Scott. You gotta take your time, like, it's like, oh! Trying not to get no splinters in my booty hole, you understand? And then my wife only allowed me three sheets a day, so I had to get creative. I had to learn origami so I can be able to get. I turned it into a swan and then to a table football so I can get the crack. I ain't eat finger food for a while. I wasn't licking nothing off my finger. Toilet paper shortage, can't do that. But it got nervous around the house. Man, wasn't no money coming in. I was getting scared, man. We were down our last two rows of Scott. Two packs of top ramen noodle. We had creamy chicken. And motherfucker beef and shit, and we got nervous. I was like, all right, this is getting crazy around here. And I had to call a family meeting. Family meeting! They were like, what's wrong, Daddy? What's wrong? Well, we ain't got no money coming in. We down our last two rows of Scott. I don't know what we gonna do. What you think we should do, Daddy? I said, well, I done came to the conclusion. Somebody might have to sell some ass around here. My wife said, get your ass out there then. I said, I'm going. I wonder how much money I can get for this man pussy out here. I done lost a little weight. maybe somebody want it. I thank the Lord Jesus, that the Tempe Improv saw it in their heart to open back up. Won't he do it? Thank you, Jesus. The Lord saved my ass. It would have been weird out there. I'm sitting out there with them two masks on. He's like, man, your voice sound familiar. When you on there with Mr. Brown, when you on Breaking Bad, man, shut the fuck up. Turn the light out and leave the money on the dresser, motherfucker. This shit got hard on me, though, man. Before this shit hit, I was the Lavell Crawford. You understand me? The Lavell Crawford. See, y'all don't understand. Y'all like, who are you? I'm the Lavell motherfucking Crawford. I was in BET, Last Comic Standing, Breaking Bad TV shows out of Yin Yang. I was on a 30 City tour with Mike Epp. Hey, I appreciate the claps. And I appreciate you not clapping, sir. Thank you very much. Like, I still don't know who the fuck you are. You're like, oh, really? Not a lot of things. But yes, I was the fucking Lavell Crawford. But this pandemic hit. I used to walk around my house talking shit. I did. You know, I walk around the house. You know why these lights on his house? Huh? You know why these lights on his house? Anybody know? These jokes keep these goddamn lights on his house. Anybody else can tell a fucking joke to put some lights on in the house? Anybody? Anybody tell a joke to keep the lights on in the house? I don't know. I know you don't. You know why it's food in that refrigerator? You know why it's food in that fucking refrigerator? These jokes keep that food in the refrigerator. Anybody tell them don't keep the fucking food in the refrigerator? I'm the big dog around here. That pandemic hit, I went from big dog to puppy dog real quick. I went from the Lavell Crawford to Vail like a motherfucker. I walk around the house humble as hell, like. They was like, what's up, big dog? No, not right now. No, I ain't big dog right now. I'm more like kitty cat. I ain't no. And I was being real nice. I was talking to my wife. I was like, hey, boo, you think I can get a little of that orange juice? She talking to me like I wasn't a kid. Didn't your ass just have some orange juice earlier like everybody else? Get some water, motherfucker. Because your jokes didn't pay for this damn orange juice. But can your jokes take the trash out? Huh? Can your joke take the trash out? Huh? Can your joke cut the grass, huh? I was crying like a zombie. Why you forsaking me, Lord? I used to be the Zeal of Aircraft. I didn't fell off so fast. I didn't even go through the stages of drug abuse and alcohol. I didn't get a documentary. Hell, I didn't even get a unsung on TV one, y'all. Why you do me like this, Jesus? And then my mama called. You need to call the unemployment office and get your unemployment. I said, oh, Lord. I went from 30 City to now I'm calling the unemployment office. My mama stop all that bullshit crying. Shit, I called him. I got 6 months back stimulus plus my unemployment. I'm getting $2,200 every other week. I say, shit, what's that number again? I didn't even say, hold on. I just clicked the fuck over. A little black girl answered, yes, this is the Keisha at the unemployment office. How can I help you? I say, hi, the Keisha. I heard you're giving people back stimulus money plus their unemployment. That's correct, sir. We're really helping people out. I'd like to help myself out, too. And can I get my money, too, sir? Let's get your name in the files and get you going. What's your name, sir? I went, Lavell Crawford. She's like, the Lavell Crawford. I just hung up the fucking phone. I said, this hell was about to set me up. She's gonna have me on Instagram Live and TMZ. Guess who just filed for his unemployment? D. Lavell Crawford. That's right, D. Lavell. When my cousin, who ain't worked in 30 years, said he was getting $3,500, I called Lakeisha right the fuck back. I was like, hi, Lakeisha, you know who the fuck this is. Yes, this is the Lavell Crawford. Could you put my name in them files so I can get my $3,500 right now? My shit's still pending. ain't got my shit. But, I mean, you know, that's one thing I got to salute my wife. She got me through this shit, man. That's why I love black love. I love it. I love it. I love white love, too, if you got it. I love it. For real, my wife been there, man. I mean, shit, she been, you know, and I got my wife, you know, I was weighing 550 pounds. I don't even know why she was with me. I'm glad she never woke up, you know what I'm saying? For real, I mean, and people always want to try to get you with smaller people, you know, bigger people when you're a big person. You need to get a girl your size. I don't got nothing problem with big women. I think y'all love you, but damn it, I can't be with you. All we gonna do is argue. Why you sweating? Why you sweating? You eat my chicken, did you eat my damn chicken? We couldn't do nothing freaky. Yeah. Move your titties to the left. Move yours to the right. Hold your stomach up. Hold your stomach up. Try to go down on her. I can't even find it. I'm down there. Her thigh wet as hell. I said, you know what? Let's put our clothes on and go to Golden Corral. It was so hot down there, it felt like I had a hoodie sweater on. My wife been with me through the thick and thin. I'm telling you, I mean the real thick. She's so beautiful, she used to find my dick for both of us, you know? So I'm like, hold your stomach up and don't let it down till I get out of there. I'm like, okay. She like, she down there working on the Chevy truck. I'm like, you find it? Yeah, I found him, but he's very scared now. And she was brave. She let me get on top every once in a while. I'd be on top for a minute, and my arm start shaking. She said, lay on your back. Lay on your back. You getting tired, You getting tired. The last time you collapsed on me, I missed a week of work. Love her to death, man. I'd kill her dead if she ever left me. You ain't going nowhere, woman. You my boo. I love. That's real love when you threaten to kill you. When I say, I'd kill you dead if you ever left me. I mean, I ain't giving nobody else. That's real love right there. How many men would kill their woman if they left? One crazy man back there. You blessed, sir. You blessed. Women like a crazy man. If your man won't willing to kill you, ain't saying kill you for real, but if shit got real deep, he'd fuck your ass up. You know what I'm saying? And women like crazy men, like crazy men, like crazy women. They do. Dude be bitten in the crazy woman. They say they got some good booty. That's what it is. They ain't going nowhere. Dude be like, she crazy ass heifer going through my email. She inboxing heifers that I don't know. She all going through my text message. She a crazy as shit. She be watching me while I sleep. I'm sick of her ass. I say, well, leave her. Leave her then. He's like, nah, I ain't got that. And women like crazy dudes. They like them crazy. He be watching your ass while you sleep. Be driving down the highway at high speed, just staring at you, ain't even looking at the road. Like, you need to watch the road. You act so stupid all the time. You know, like, you crazy dude. You leave him. You sneak off to your mama house. He pull up in front of your mama house at 3 o'clock in the morning, honking the horn. Your mama come to the door. She don't want to talk to you. This ain't between me and you, Miss Brown. Let her come to the door, and I'll put the gas can back in the trunk. But if she don't come to the door, I'm going to burn both you hoes up right now. Her mom be like, girl, go out there and get your husband. If your daddy would have did that, he would have threatened to kill me. I probably would have still been with him. Man. But there's been some crazy times. That's why I'm glad I'm married. I got me a woman to stay by. I ain't trying to be out in this world. This world got crazy. Shit, I live in Houston, Texas. We fucking had a snowstorm. I legitimately think the Lord is on his way back. I just want to be outside with my suitcase because he coming back. It's snow in Houston, Texas. Now, if you ever been in Houston, Texas, it's like Tempe. You know, Tempe get around, I think the lowest y'all get about 45. That's like Houston. Houston don't get around about 45, 50, but it get about 399 degrees all summer long, even at fucking night. It gets so hot, my air conditioner be crying. What the fuck wrong with that shit? So when we had fucking sleet and snow fucking come down, it shut down the whole fucking city. Our electricity went off and everything. And I was just thankful I was in a better neighborhood where I had, you know, had a couple of white folks that could help me out. Because white folks, I love my black people, don't get me wrong, but we are not good in apocalyptic situations. I'm sorry, black folk. You can get offended if you want to. I don't give a fuck. But you know you ain't ready for a zombie crisis. You ain't ready for electricity going the fuck out. If electricity go off in black people's house, we look at the bill. That's what we like. I don't know what's going on. Call the company, because I paid that shit. I know. I paid it. The whole street lights out. That's their business. I want to make sure our shit ain't cut out. White folk know how to handle themselves during this fucked up shit. Black folk be like, man, I had some black friends die during the blackout. Niggas didn't have no heat, gonna bring the grill in the house. Niggas slow roasted to death, sitting up in heaven, smelling like brisket. I just wonder who was the genius that said, let's bring the grill in the house. Now you thinking, no, he ain't. I was hanging out with my white friend. He bought a generator. I said, why you buying that generator? He's like, you never know. I said, but why you buying that shotgun? You never know. why you putting storm windows up? You never fucking know. Shit, why you got a pit bull and an alligator? I don't know. I bought all that shit. I bought that generator. Didn't even know how to use it, but I was sitting up here mad at the motherfucker. I said, now, how the fuck he work this shit? He had to come up, fuck, you gotta fucking put gas in it. You gotta turn the motherfucker on, and then you plug shit into it. And he took that motherfucking gas in there, and we turned that bitch on. We started plugging everything, all the lights on in the house. We helped out a couple of niggas across the street. Hey, let me get some of that electricity. Play it. What's going on, dog? I'm selling electricity. I was the company then. I called the electric company and said, fuck you. Turn my shit off, bitch. I ain't never paying another fucking electric bill in my fucking life. I got a generator, bitch. All I need is a half a tank of gas, and I can keep my lights on all goddamn night. We had gas. We thought the oven was off. We found out you can light the burners. I was like, well, goddamn. I don't need none of that shit no more. I called the gas company. I said, don't turn that shit on no more. We gonna keep the gas on, bitch. Just keep it on. We gonna run it the way we fucking want to. Only problem we had was the water. The water was hard because we you know, it seemed like when the water ain't working, it seemed like that's when you gotta shit the most. It's like, you know, it was no water coming in the toilet. My wife said, get a bucket of water and hold the lever down and just let it flush down. I was like, all right. I took a monster shit. And I said, that can't stay in there. That's gonna be worse than the pandemic. I took a bucket of water and I flushed that sucker down. That water went. Rrr, I don't know where it went, but it's always that one little turd that stay the fuck around. It's sitting around in the toilet. No matter how much water I put in that son of a bitch, it wouldn't go down. But the beautiful thing is we made it through all this bullshit. We made it through all this shit and we realized we smarter than one or two, you know what I'm saying? Everybody in here, ain't nobody can say their life was worse than nobody else. We all went through it, motherfucker. It all was bad for every fucking body. I thought Jesus was coming back, but I said, I guess he gonna wait because he's got to put a mask on. He gonna wait. For real, because I was ready to go to heaven. I know heaven off the chain. Kobe Bryant out there, you know, the basketball team undefeated. You know that? You know, it's good comedy out there. They got George Carlin, Richard Pryor, Bernie Mac. Shit, comedy off the chain out there. They got good music. Aretha Franklin. Aretha Franklin out there. You got Prince, but God made him put on pants, you know? Michael Jackson out there, but he can't. He had to stay away from the small angels. Oh, fuck you. Fuck all of you, because when he was on Earth, you son of a bitch said, yeah, he fucked them kids as soon as he died. Oh, my God. I love Michael Jackson like everybody else. I was the only fat kid on the block with a beater jacket that didn't zip up. None of the zippers. I mean, none of the zippers. Even the side zippers, like, you pick, you know it. Yeah, everybody up there. I mean, hell, Whitney Houston might be up there. I ain't for sure. What? I ain't up there. Shut the fuck up. You ain't up there either. Like she gonna, she, you know, when she was on Earth, she had a little suspect shit going on. They asked her, Whitney, we heard you bought some crack. Show me the receipt. Come on now. Y'all blame poor Bobby Brown. Bobby Brown was a mess, but he didn't fuck her up. They fuck each other up. You understand? Let's keep it real. Stop fronting. Y'all be fronting too damn much. That's what's wrong with the fucking world today. You know? We front too much. Let's keep it the truth, man. I mean, we don't know. I ain't in heaven. When I get up there, I come back down. Yeah, Whitney up there. You know? She just like Rick James. Rick James up there part-time. Yeah. He out there part-time. Soon as he get done performing, all right, Rick, get back downstairs. You done performing. Last time we left you up here unsupervised, you snorted all the clouds. He going back downstairs. Fire and desire. Well, I'm glad you desired the fire, because that's where the fuck you going. But you know, the thing about it, you learn how to survive. The only problem I had is I had a dog still. I was like, dumb motherfucker, I don't need no fucking dog right now in a pandemic. Get your stupid ass out of here. And that motherfucker had a nerve to get sick, you know. And that's when you need to keep your hood light. And I fucking feel sorry for that motherfucker. Back in the day, my dog gets sick, I throw him in the trash can. You know what I'm saying? And I know you white people don't want to hear that. Fuck you. You get sick, motherfucker, I don't even go to the doctor. I'd be damned if I pay to take your dumb ass to the doctor. We used to get raggedy-ass dogs that live fucking forever. I had a dog that lost two legs. He walking on two legs. That motherfucker, he walking like a supermodel all the time. That motherfucker lived till he was 138. Fuck you, dog. My dog got sick on a peace bid, cost us $6,000. And then he gonna come home and shit on the floor. I kicked $6,000 out of his ass. Yes, I did. I certainly did. Disrespectful motherfucker. He can't even protect us. He can't do shit for us. He can't kill nothing but time. That's it. He kills time. All this shit going on. I click on the news, white people that lost their damn mind. 2021 started off with a bang. Why? Donald Trump, I said it before, I said it again, he is a real nigga. I don't give a fuck. You know he is. He did more nigga shit. When he lost, he lost and got impeached. And he did what any nigga would do. He said, I ain't going nowhere. Give a fuck, bitch. You need to count that shit again. Donald, you fired, bitch. I put on everything I love, huh? You better count that shit again. I ain't going no motherfucker where. Bitch, I smacked the shit out of you. You say I lost again, bitch. Did you count? Did you count? Count that, bitch. Go get my shit out of the trunk. I don't give a fuck. I ain't going nowhere. You fired, bitch. You impeached. I don't even know what peach is. I like peach cobbler. You better bring me some peach cobbler. Because I ain't going fucking nowhere. And when he lost, that's when them good old boys lost their mind. Them motherfuckers, I watching the news, and I seen them white people on the news. Because when you see black people snap, we just march. We shall overcome. That's it. We like march down the street. We got a flag. No justice, no peace. Black pride, black power. You wear a little T-shirt. That's it. You see one crazy dude throw a firebomb. It was him. We don't. We pretty peaceful, but when you see white people on the news snapping the fuck off, you be like, what didn't happen? You see the white people that in that Capitol building, them motherfuckers was snapping. You heard, we're not going to take it. No, we're not going to take it. We're not going to take it anymore. Had a 12-gauge and a bloodhound. Them motherfuckers, they was snapping. These white boys was snapping. They climbing the wall. We're not going to take it. They climbing the wall, but the stairs was right around the corner. The motherfuckers said, fuck the stairs. We climbed this wall. A couple of them fell out the wall. We're not gonna take it. They were snapping the fuck out. But I love black people. Black people always say this shit. You see? See, that's white folk. Because if that was us, I said, that'll never be us. First of all, I think we were invited. Like, come on, you're American just like it. We're not going to take it, and you're not going to take it. Come on. Like, what time y'all going down there? 7:30 sharp. In the morning? What you mean by sharp? You mean right at 7:30? Yes, 7:30 fucking sharp. We're not going to take it. Brother be like, shit, 7:30, damn, I don't get off till 9. I'm be tired in the motherfucker trying to wake up that early. Are y'all gonna still be there at noon? And let me keep it real with you. White folks don't play, they plan that shit. They said they had blueprints and everything up. Like, all right, we're going to be up there at 7:30 sharp. You hear that? 7:30 sharp, we got it. Jebediah, I want you. I want you to coordinate all the F-150s. But I got an F-250. Bring it on. We need it. Because we're not going to take it. Y'all blocked the Capitol building. Now, this is what I need you to do, Enos. Enos, I want you to get as many guys, get on boots, and climb the wall. But there's some stairs around the corner. You shut the fuck up, Jacob. You always got something to say. We don't want to climb the fucking stairs. We're going to climb the fucking wall. We're going to surprise them. Because we're not going to take it. What you want me to do, George? I want you to paint your chest and put a buffalo horn helmet on your head. That's going to really fuck them up. And I love the security guard. They said it was a hero. That motherfucker ain't never had an emergency ever at that damn building. For 30 years, his ass was sitting looking at the monitor, just looking at it. Hey, my DoorDash came yet. He looked out on that monitor and he heard, we're not going to take it. What the fuck is that? Is that a buffalo running up here? Where all them F-150s come from? He started running in them badass shoes. His feet was killing him. I need backup. My feet is killing me. Bring me some Dr. Scholes. But the thing about it is, man, it's so funny out here. We've been blessed, man. We've been blessed. I thank God. I thank God for where we are now, because this shit was crazy. I hit it where they lost their mind. But I realized one thing. In adversity, there's always progress and perseverance. And I look at my son. I brought him on stage and shit. But, sometimes we forget. I always tell people, don't ever be upset how far you came. You know, don't ever be upset. It may not be where you are. But be happy at your success, because you was over there. Now you up here. Just look at it. May be 2 feet or it may be 3 miles. But never get comfortable where you're at. Don't ever just sit, I'm good right here. No, fuck that. You know, good today, but ain't going to be good tomorrow. Always strive for better. You know what I'm saying? You always know where you are. No, and never get mad, because nobody owe you shit. There's always things that are important. Like my son will come up to me, Dad, I just want to let you know. He goes, I really hate school. I said, if you don't get your little entitled ass downstairs and log in on that goddamn computer and go to class. I wish I could go to class sitting in my Superman underwear, eating a bowl of cereal and deleting fucking teachers. You know, like people, my cousin talking about that shit, talking about, I'm sick of my job. Bitch, you work from home. She got fired from one job at the house, being late. Still complaining with her ignorant ass. My son talking about he hates school. Motherfucker, I hated school. Every motherfucker, I had to walk 2 miles to the bus stop, chased by a pit bull and a Rottweiler. And it was one dog. That's what I'm trying to tell you. And I don't know how this dog knew my bus schedule. But this motherfucker chased me every day. He was my motivation to get to school. I got up there, a little fat boy running like a pig, went hell. And I get up there and had to help the bus driver change the tire. Then make sure to look out so the police wouldn't get him because he didn't have a driver's license. I get to school, got my ass whooped by both bullies. The white bully for being black and the black bully for being fat. And then I get to class and forgot my homework, so the teacher, evil ass, gave me an F+. The fuck you give a nigga an F+, for? You a dirty motherfucker. It could have been a straight fucking F. You gonna give me a plus on it, bitch? That's knock your muck ass out. Then I get home, my mama told me, how the hell you get an F+? I said, look here, lady. That's beside the point. I got chased by a fucking mutant pit bull Rottweiler. Walk up a fucking hill 2 miles. Change the fucking tire. I'm 8, all right? And to get to school and get my ass whooped twice before I get in class. Hell with that F+. I got an A in survival. And I love my mom, and she didn't never get comfortable. She got a better job. Only thing I liked about school was free lunch. I love free lunch. I love that free lunch. I used to love Spaghetti Tuesday and Pizza Friday, man. I'll save 2 tickets for Pizza Friday, boy, and I get 2 pieces of pizza and scrape all the toppings off one piece and put it on one. It'd be like a meat lover's. Oh, shit. Give me one of them juice cups. Woo! I love that shit. I used to fuck that up every Friday. But then my mama got a better job, and then she made 35 cents more than the equivalency, so I couldn't get free lunch or the reduced lunch. And so I had to take my fucking lunch to school, so I had Vienna sausage and crackers. And she used to put my milk in a mason jar so it tastes like apple butter. But one day she did, on every Friday she would make what I wanted. For lunch, like one week she made me meatloaf, but this week she made me a meatloaf sandwich. You know, after the excess meatloaf on white bread with some Miracle-Whip, off the chain. You understand? But she said, "Well, we out of meatloaf, baby, but it's Friday. Whatever you want, I'll make it for you." And I said, "Well, I love a peanut butter and jelly sandwich." She said, "Peanut butter and jelly coming up." I said, "Cool." She go to the cabinet. "Oh, we out of bread, baby. I'm sorry." I said, "Oh, it's cool. Just give me some Vienna sausage and crackers. I drink my apple butter milk and go on about my business." She said, "Wait a minute. I found some bread. I found these hot dog buns. I just put some peanut butter and jelly on the hot dog buns." I said, "No, no." No, that's not going to work. We're not going to do that right now. He's like, yeah, well, bread is bread. I said, I'm not arguing with you, Dad. Bread is bread. In this house, bread is bread. But at that school, where I'm already getting an F+, I'm getting my ass whooped by both bullies, and you dress me like a Best Buy manager. Because I got these penny loafers on, but my feet swell up too much. I can't even put pennies in them. And then you got these slacks with pleats in them that push my stomach up, make it look like I got a high pussy. You know what I'm saying? And then you claim this is an Eye shirt, and everybody know Eye got alligators on it. But I'm sitting up here with every fat animal in the animal kingdom. I got a water buffalo shirt. I got a cow shirt. I got an elephant shirt. No fucking alligator shirt. And now you're going to make me a peanut butter and jelly sandwich on the hot dog bun? I think not, lady. I think not. I'll take my Vienna sausages and my apple butter milk and I'll be on my way. I'm going to make it for you anyway. I said, yeah, fine, I won't eat it at school. I got to school. I didn't even want to go to lunch. Lunch is my favorite part of the day. I didn't even go to lunch. The bell rang for lunch. The teacher said, Lavell, aren't you going to lunch? I said, no, Miss Wallace, I'm not hungry today. I'm trying to cut back. I'm just staying here with you. She said, oh, no, not today. You're not going to stay here with me. This is my only time I get away from you, badass kid. You taking your chunk ass outside, and I can't believe you ain't hungry. You always hungry. So I went outside, kids changing lunch. I traded some of my Cheetos for some of your Doritos. I traded you an Oreo for a piece of your Twinkie. What you got, Val? I said, hey, I'm cutting back today, fellas. I'm trying to get rid of this high pussy, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to get me a real alligator on my shirt. But the black bully, he didn't believe me. The black bully, his name was Erg. And Erg, he wasn't your normal third grader. He had a beard and a mustache. He had chest hair. He worked the night shift as the janitor at the school. And his son was in kindergarten. He said, you're a damn lie. I know your fat ass got something good. You had meatloaf last week. You didn't give me none of that. You don't give me some of that damn whatever you got in your bag. He snatched my bag, and he saw that hot dog bun. And, you know, third graders, they see a hot dog. That's like filet mignon. Oh, shit. Lavell got a hot dog, y'all. I said, Erg, looks can be deceiving. You know, it's not necessary a hot dog. I said, shut your fat ass up and break me off a piece of that hot dog right now before I whoop your ass. I said, I just don't want you to be surprised when I break it. He said, shut your punk ass up, fat, high pussy boy. I said, there's no room for insults. So I broke that motherfucking hot dog bun. He seen that peanut butter and jelly ooze out of there. He snapped. What kind of fucking appetite you got? You putting peanut butter and jelly on a hot dog bun? You ain't got no mustard or ketchup? And I broke down. I said, my mama ran out of bread. So she had to make me a peanut butter and jelly sandwich on a hot dog bun. He started laughing. Ah, Lavell poor. He can't afford bread. And I ran off crying, and I had to eat with the faculty the rest of the year. And they didn't even know I was a student because I was dressed like the history teacher. Like, hey, you got a high pussy too. I say, fuck you, Mr. Wilson. One other reason I don't like school, because my mama made, she got mad at me because I wasn't taking care of my hair. As you can see, my son got a lot of hair on his damn head. I used to have a lot of hair just like that back when I was little. I don't have none now for gravity reason. I don't know. I get this booty hair out, I'm going to put it right up there, you know. I don't have the hair, but back then I had a hair full of hair. And my mama talking about, you got lint in your damn hair. You don't brush it, you don't comb it, you don't take care of it. I'm cutting it off. She cut all my hair off. And you see how my head shaped now. I just didn't grow into this. This is how my head looked back then. And she cut all my hair off. And with this point on my head, soon as I walked in school, the superintendent saw me and just really assumed that I was special needs right off the bat. And she said, Lord, they're coming out the woodwork. Come on, baby. Come on in the camp. Come on. Come on. We got the class for you. Sheila, we got another one. We got another one. Keep the door open. Where we going? You going to special needs, sweetheart? Come on now. I know that's why you here. No, ma'am. I'm not in special needs. Come on, baby. Look at your damn head. I mean, you ain't getting no oxygen to your head. Come on now. Come on in here. Go on and sit in the class. I said, ma'am, I'm not special. Everybody's special, sweetheart, but you more special than others. Come on now. I said, ma'am, I'm not retarded. You watch your damn mouth. You would not say retarded in there. You sound retarded saying retarded. Now get your special ass in there and sit down. Man, I got in that damn special need class. Now, I don't pick on special need people. I think they're some of the sweetest people in the world. I worked with them before, so I know. But I'm sitting in this class. My mama couldn't get off work to get me out of there. And I'm sitting there. I'm mad as shit. I get beat up. Now, I'm special needs. This is real fucked up. As soon as I sat down, one of the special needs kids, he saw me. He walked right up to me and went, hey, how you doing? I heard about your hot dog incident, and I just want to let you know, I know you don't have any hot dogs at home, but hot dogs are my favorite food, and my mother always give me 3 hot dogs plus raisins, because raisins are my other favorite food. And since you don't have a lunch, I'm willing to share one of my hot dogs with you and some of my raisins. Would you like that? I looked at him, and I was already mad. I looked right at him, and I was like, fuck your pussy-ass hot dog, and fuck your punk-ass raisins. He went, what? He ain't never been talked to like that. He was like, what? I said, fuck your pussy-ass hot dog and fuck your punk-ass raisin. He's like, why would you say something like that? I was going to share it with you. I said, fuck your pussy-ass hot dog and fuck your punk-ass raisin. Fuck my hot dog, you know, they real sensitive. And when they cry, they'll cry your ass into the penitentiary. That motherfucker. Fuck my hot dog? And fuck my pussy-ass raisin? I was gonna give you some. That motherfucker started crying. I was like, what the fuck going on? That motherfucker. I said, hey, dog, I'm sorry. Give me a hot dog. Stop crying, dog. Give me a raisin. Next thing you know, the superintendent and the principal and the security guard came in. What's going on? Joey, calm down. What's wrong? Joey, calm down. What's wrong? Joey, calm down. Look at me. Listen to me.
He said, fuck my pussy ass hot dog. And fuck my punk ass raisins.
Did you say that to him, Lavell? I looked at their ass. Next thing you know, I went, Fuck, they already thought I was special needs anyway. Next thing you know, we going back and forth. All the other special needs kids got to cry. And I know somebody, and I can't believe he talking about special needs children. I happen to have a special needs child at home. I said, well, I don't know you, bitch. I'm not talking about you. I don't know nothing about your life. And if you got a special needs child, what the fuck you doing here? Apparently, you needed a break. He don't even know your ass gone. He's sitting up in the house right now. Mama! 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 That's how some of y'all gonna cry and get that vaccine. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I've been Lavell Crawford. It was a great show, brother. Good job. We proud. Mama proud.
Hey, man, Floyd said y'all needed me.
Man, you know I always need you, man.
I knew I'd be back, man. I was a little nervous.
I know. You know how we play, but, you know. Yeah. But Junior was asking me a question, something I forgot about. He was asking me how much he supposed to get paid, and I was just remembering that you grabbed a check.
Right.
Yeah. Let me get that back for you.
You want the check back?
Yeah, man. I mean, dude, you got to get paid.
I mean, he 10. What you going to do with $1,200?
Hey, look. I mean, we'll worry about that later. Just get Junior the check, man. Thank you, dog. You be careful. You need a ride back?
I mean, my rent due on the 1st.
All right. Yeah. You know what, man? We'll say a prayer for you. I got to go to prayer meeting this week, man. I appreciate that, man. No problem. Hey, we love you, though, dog.
I love you, too, man.
Now you're earning now. Yeah. But you know I need my 10%.
I need you to chip in on that cable bill. But just stop arguing about it. We'll argue at home. You got $1,200 in your pocket. You got a new job. You're going to make much more money, huh?
Yeah.
Team Crawford, baby.